CNN talks to Mark User's lawyer, big mistake as shocked viewers hear what she lets slip. There's currently quite a bit of controversy centering around Roy Moore after Beverly Young Nelson alleged that the Republican candidate for Senate attempted to rape her 4 decades ago. Anxious to bring negative publicity to the GOP, CNN recently jumped at the chance to bring the woman's parasitic lawyer, the infamous Gloria Allred, on for a few words, but that would be a big mistake as even their liberal viewers were left shocked to hear what she let slip on live television. Mad World News has reported extensively on Beverly Young Nelson and her claims against Alabama Senate hopeful Roy Moore. Unfortunately for her, it seems that her story is falling apart quicker than she could make it up, as quite a few things simply don't add up. For one, the signature in a 1977 yearbook she has been touting as proof of their acquaintance appears to be a forgery. As if that wasn't bad enough, the writing in the yearbook appears to have been written in 2 different colored inks as well. Then, there's the fact it was signed D.A., but Roy Moore wasn't D.A. at the time. As if that's all not bad enough, the fact that her own stepson has come out in support of Moore, saying that his stepmother is lying, isn't doing her case any favors either. To top it all off, a body language expert has analyzed videos of Booth Moore and his accuser, saying that both were showed overwhelming evidence that the politician was innocent in all this while his accuser appears to be acting. Of course, CNN was all too excited to get a chance to slam a Republican candidate as they brought Gloria Allred, Nelson's scumbag lawyer, on their show, but things wouldn't exactly go according to plan. As it turns out, the woman would let something slip about the yearbook that has shocked viewers on both the left and right side of the political aisle. According to the Gateway pundit, Allred was asked by Wolf Blitzer if the signature was legitimate and whether she would go on record to say it flatly was not a forgery. However, rather than assure viewers that the signature was not forged, she dodged the question. Even worse yet, she was pressed several times to give a definitive answer but wouldn't do so. As if that wasn't enough to make anyone question her honesty over this signature, she later appeared on Don Lemon's show and did the same exact thing, dodging questions rather than giving a direct answer. Sadly, the signature isn't the only thing she doesn't want to address. In the end, this is looking more and more like a Democrat hit job meant to do one thing, keep a member of the GOP out of the Senate and fill the seat with a leftist politician. The left can't win fairly, so they're trying to cheat. Too bad for them. America is sick of their ways and all the fake news. That's why President Donald Trump was elected, and it's why Roy Moore may very well find himself becoming the newest member of the Senate.